Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.2, Problem 2. This is Section 7.2, Problem number 2. It says, look up the value for z in the chart and draw the graph and shade in the appropriate region, and the z value is 2.54. So there's a four-step process to look this up in the chart. Step one is write the number so that it has two places after the decimal. This one already has two places after the decimal. Sometimes you have to fill in zeros or you have to round it off a little bit, but we have step one all set. Step two, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So we'll have 2.5, the rightmost digit is the 4, it'll come off to the side. Step three, put a .0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So that 4 becomes .04. Step four, go to the chart. The digits from the left, 2.5 for this particular problem, tell you what row of the chart to look in. And the digit from the right with the .0 in front tells you what column of the chart to look in. So you're going to go to that chart. You're going to go to the 2.5 row. You're going to go to the 0.4 column, and you'll see where those intersect. Now, the chart is on two pages. One page is for positive values to look up. The other page is for negative values to look up. So make sure you pay attention. This is a positive 2.54. Very common mistake. So if you look at the 2.5 row, the 0.4 column, see where they intersect. They will intersect at 0.9945. Now that's the answer. So again, what does that answer mean? 9945 means what? So all these problems involve the bell curve. And you put some numbers at the bottom of that bell curve. And what those numbers are how many standard deviations away from the average value you are. So under the center, you put 0. You're 0 standard deviations away from average. On the right end, where you stop bothering to draw, you put a positive 3. On the left end, a negative 3. So that means 3 standard deviations bigger than the average, 3 standard deviations smaller than the average. And then by eye, you can fill in 1, 2, 3. And on the left half, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So what we've looked up, 2.54, goes along that bottom. So between 2 and 3 is 2.5. And 2.54 is essentially 2.5. So we can figure 2.54. And now the number from that chart that we found, 9945, is the probability of being to the left of the value that you just looked up. And I'll indicate that area of our graph with these diagonal lines by shading it in like that. And the probability of being in that shaded area is 0.9945. So with some type of round off, about a 99.5% probability, which is very close to 100%.